right, hey, I'm glad to see people in a room. We're rather unusual what we're doing here. We're a harmonica quartet. And this, you had some great harmonica groups in the 30s and 40s and 50s. They're all gone. Culture's changed in America. And I'm just going to explain these instruments quickly. Pete plays the chromatic harmonica, which is I love to play, but I'm stuck playing this today. So that's And then Bob is playing the bass, which is equivalent to bass fiddle. My wife plays the 2-foot chord harmonica, and I'm playing the 2-foot chord harmonica, which produces rhythms, different chords, like piano, guitar, background. So we're going to do something that you'll probably never see again. And all the guys that were great players, they're all gone. And it's a culture that went away, and I play with some great harmonica players and great groups in the past, but I'm interested in an instrument that was way before me, so all these guys, they're gone, they left me alone, but I play with some great fellas. We're going to do some stuff for you. We're going to play four numbers, and you'll find this interesting. Our first one is Blue Spanish Eyes, Lady of Spain. Thank you. a swinging version of My Romance, featuring Pete Bronzio on a harmonica. I taught him some of my secrets, and I'm starting to worry about him. He's getting so good. But anyway, and Bob playing those nice bass lines with Val playing chords. We have a big sound. And here we go, My Romance. that performance, I'm leaving, man. Show's over. Do some stuff now. I have some great tracks. Really can't find great musicians to play with down here. It's very hard. And they require a lot of work. So music changing the way it did. Only a good player who's solo by themselves, they always have tracks. I have some great tracks, and I'm going to play some nice American songbook stuff for you. Okay? And we're going to start the first one. It's going to be called Satin Doll by Duke Ellington. Here it goes. Great piano, great bass, great drums. Only thing with these tracks, they don't They don't play with you, so you get into trouble with them. Okay. Where should I commit, Rich? Virtually play anything. I've played everything on this harmonica, from bebop jazz to highbrow classical pieces, piano concertos, and try to show what the instrument can do. It's not really an easy instrument to play. It's very complex. And I just want to tell you something about this a little bit. You have some musicians in the audience. This little button, you know, it's hard to see if you're far back. You push that slide in. It's like your black keys on a piano. It gives you your sharps and your flats. So you have all the notes in this, so I'll give you a demonstration. We play a regular diatonic scale, right? Now I'm going to play chromatic scale with the slide. Right, Doug? So there you go, man. So all the notes are on this. You just got to be able to know where they are. And also, people don't know, saxophone, trumpet, clarinet, it's a melody instrument. I can play octaves on this. You can't play octaves on a trumpet, saxophone, or a clarinet. You can play it on a piano or a guitar. And how you play octaves, I played a lot of octaves just now, but people didn't really know what I was doing. What I'm doing is splitting the low octave on the left side of my mouth with the high octave on the right side of my mouth. So if I'm playing 20 notes in 5 seconds, my mouth has to be exactly the right. Yeah. They don't know, you know. So, all right, well, look, I'm going to do another standard, and it's called Fly Me to the Moon. All right. Operating this equipment is harder to play. Thank you. of all time, I guess maybe second to Stardust, I don't know, but so The Wizard of Oz, a 1939 movie, and so many great musicians have done a lot with this because there's so much subject matter you can do. And I have my rendition of Over the Rainbow. Thank you.
3 hours to go.
Yeah. That could last.
11 o'clock.
A swing and jazz number. I haven't played this in a long time, so I hope I nail it good. And it's called, it's a really rocking rendition of There'll Never Be Another You. Super nice. He's a tremendous player. I'm glad he's here. Anyway, he'll appreciate what I'm doing. This is a beautiful trumpet solo. It's called Moon Indigo, you know, beauty. And I'm going to try to make this harmonica sound like that trumpet, you know. And I'm loaded for playing a harmonica. It does not sound like a harmonica. Violin, horns, you know. So here we go. I'm going to give my best with Moon Indigo. Duke Ellington of them.
Thank you.
what time is this thing at?
11:30.
I'm good, okay.
Oh, that's bad. I gotta play a lot of the songs.
Yeah.
A fraud. I've been doing it up to now, but I'm out of ammunition now.
Okay.
I'm gonna do something called Sea Jam Blues. It really smokes. It's a jazz blues. Here it is, man. And there's a part that the trumpet comes in, and I play right on top of the horn. I sound exactly like the trumpet. Anyway, that's what I think. You guys are. If I don't do it right, laugh at me.
All right. Here it is. Sea Jam Blues. I hope. That's all I can do. Should have somebody operate this thing for me. Okay. I've survived so far.
He's doing good.
All right.
One, two, a one, two, three. Small crowds of people, you know, and they pay just one guy, so they're happy. Don't make any difference if you're good or bad. They just pay X amount of dollars. You know, I happen to be pretty good, but so what? But anyway, and most of them don't understand, but they do know that I play better than their grandfather. They always thought was great. So. And if I get a few background musicians in the crowd, whoa, you know, once in a while, this is great because there's some big boys out here today, musical giants. I'm glad to see them. Anyway, I'm gonna. Play play a classical piece, something totally different. A cappella. I wish I had an orchestra, but it'd really be great if I had these arrangements. But realistically, you have to have a lot of guys play. You have to put in a lot of time. So this is my version of Malagueña without an orchestra, and I'm going to try to fatten up the sound with different techniques that I'm going to do. Okay? Malagueña, my version. Saber Dance. It's a real great number. Like I said, I wish I had a band to play with. I used to play this with a great harmonica trio, you know, Jerry Murad's Harmonica Cats. I played with Jerry in the past, and when people really don't know who he is, but they were the famous, most famous harmonica trio that ever lived. And that hit with Peg My Heart in 1947. They were famous. They were like big stars in the 40s and 50s. And I was friends with Jerry, and when Jerry passed away in 1997, I played for him, the guys that they had left. I knew all his numbers, all his stuff. But this is pretty much Jerry's version of Saber Dance without the chord and bass harmonica. And here it goes. Thank you. the bow and draw. See, like when you're playing a horn, not that a horn's easy, but we, Jerry Murat couldn't play this when he was 70. He didn't have the wind capacity anymore. I'm a pretty strong guy for my age of 75, but it's starting to get to me. Yeah, truthfully, you know, it takes a lot of wind because you staccato,
bow and draw. Beat you, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So I don't know how long I'll last with that, but I pulled it off okay. Surprise for you guys. I'm going to do something with my wife.
Oh, yeah.
And she's going to play a part of me. And she's going to literally destroy my village ego when she's finished. Yeah, she always gets a great. When I do these little jobs I do, I always feature her. People love me, you know, especially when I see that harmonica. I've never seen a harmonica before. All right, so we're going to go Kansas City.
So I got two more songs I'll play. Well, I'm thinking of a very nice ballad I'd like to do. Maybe
someone mentioned Stardust.
Yes.
I need chords for that. I need somebody to play. You know, I don't want to play that cappella.
What else could you do?
If I had a guitar or a piano, like Bobby Wilson used to do that. Yeah. I don't know. I got a nice ballad.
Should have told me.
Stardust,
yes.
Acapella.
Oh, yes.
I mean, a lot's lost, you know, you need chords, but I'll do it, okay? I got some really nice stuff, but I know a few people want to play this, but without chords and background, but I'll do it, right? Should I?
Thank you.
And I'm going to do, I'd like to do that Engelbert Humperdinck number,
Half to 11.